5 to 6 branch.
Where are you working?
So I work for BMC Software.
Good morning everyone, my name is Anwar and I am also from the 5 to 6 branch and I am working for Reuters.
Today we will be talking about Brexit. So we have been hearing about Brexit in last 1 week in your newspapers. Every day when you open your newspaper, be talking about Brexit. So what exactly Brexit is? We'll be talking about what is the Britain's role and what is the impact on European economy on Brexit. So before that, I would like to make you understand what is European Union. So European Union is formed in 1993 with 28 countries as part of the European Union to have a very socio political economical relationship with Western Europe. So as part of that, they have a free trade policy that people within the European Union can commute between these countries and have jobs and other things there.
As my colleague said, the European Union was formed in the year 1993. But before that, there was an entity called European Economic Community that was formed in 1973. So United Kingdom, as you all know, consists of four countries, which is one is England, Scotland, Wales and the Northern Ireland. So United Kingdom wanted to be a member as and when the EEC was formed, and then their first proposal was rejected because some of the countries objected to it, but finally they made it to the EEC, the then called EEC, now it is called European Union, in the year 1973. But since then, you know, the Brexit saga has been hovering all around British since the 1975. And just to give you a brief idea of what is Brexit. Brexit is a terminology used for British exit. So, you know, there were voices in and around Europe that United Kingdom, whether they should remain in the EU or they should exit. So, Prime Minister Cameron, in one of his election agendas, had mentioned that he is going to hold a referendum. A referendum is nothing but a general consensus of taking all the people into account. So it's just like an election in India. So he made his promise, but I'm sure that now he would be thinking that, you know, he made a mess of it.
All right, so what exactly is costing Britain as part of the European Union? So as part of the European Union, these are as I said, 28 countries are there. So they need to have a budget, of annual budget. And there are some weak countries, well, economically weak countries are part of this European Union. So as a part of that, there are a few major countries like UK, Germany, they have to pool in a large amount of resources to continue the running of European Union. And as part of this, the Britain has to cost around 83 billion pounds to be part of the European Union. So that's being taken out from UK economy. So that's the impact on an annual to British. So as part of this, British want to get out of this European Union and secure their economy. So as part of this, they exit. What is the impact on British people, or what is the impact on British economy? So first of all, the travel is going to cost higher for the Britain. There will be an annual expense of 4,000 to 5,000pounds for the British people because of the cost. So if you understand the European Union trades, they can bring in the goods from other European countries to the European Union countries, so which has less impact on tax and other because there is no border. They have a free movement of products. So as part of this, Britain will import few products from other European countries, and that will have an impact on tax. So tax means the people have to pay higher cost to that. And in a long term, what exactly the impact for Britain is? Britain would possibly, so this is based upon the analysis from the economists, and Britain would possibly incur a loss of 2.2% in their GDP by 2030. So that's a huge amount for a bigger economy. And with this Brit exit, I think Britain has voted for exit on 23rd, and as part of this Brit exit, the pound has been down from last 33 years. So the pound value has gone down since last 33 years. That's a huge impact of it. Second, why Britain want to exit from the European Union? Because there are a lot of job opportunity which has been taken away by the migrants from other European, because you don't need a visa to travel to UK or any other European country. So people are inflowing to Britain and taking up the jobs. So as part of the exit, there'll be more job opportunity within UK or within United Kingdom. So that has a plus point on the citizens of UK.
Just to add to what Srikanth said, UK was very much cautious. As I said, you know, since they became the part of the European Union, you know, there were many apprehensions whether they are going to continue or, you know, they are going to leave. But they were very cautious because, you know, UK is one of those few countries which chose, you know, to maintain their currency, their trading currency. If any country becomes a member of the European Union, they are bound to, you know, adopt euro as their national currency. But UK didn't do that because, you know, the sterling pound always wanted to compete with the US dollar, which is, you know, everybody knows that is the main trading currency all over the world. So who were the people who were really interested in exit, or who were those who wanted to remain in the EU? Most of the banks in England, major national banks, as well as some of the top MNCs, like for example Shell, British Telecom, Vodafone, they all stated that they want to remain in the EU, citing, you know, it is going to have a potential impact on the economy. Naturally, with a strong economy such as UK leaves a great entity such as the EU, you know, it is bound to have tremors all over the world, and we have seen that in the, you know, last week. We saw how the global markets crashed, how the pound went to its lowest rate against the US dollar. Apart from that, you know, there were also a section of the people in the United Kingdom, especially, you know, Scotland and all, in England and Ireland, who were mostly, you know, the unemployed people and the youth, because they maintained that, you know, people from outside, because the immigration laws with Europe and when you act as a country, as a single entity, they are different. So you have to abide by the rules of the European Union. So the immigration rules are somewhat lenient when compared to, you know, Britain acting as a single entity. So they thought that, you know, the Indians has the second largest population in the United Kingdom after British. So they were of the opinion that the jobs were going to, you know, Indians and other immigrants. So they wanted to put a stop to that. And also, some of the countries like Ireland, you know, they also wanted to leave the European Union.
All right. So when we talk about the job opportunity and other things, and the British people who voted against or with exit. So if you analyze, look at those numbers, the mostly the youths of the Britain have voted against European exit. That means the people who are going to get jobs or have more opportunity in UK, they have voted against exit of European Union. And the people who are above 45, which is going to be, I mean, if you look at the life expectancy in Britain, it's approximately 65 to 70. So the people who are going to, die in next 20 years is what voted with exit of European. So technically there is no benefit of, the youths doesn't see any benefit of European exit. At the same time, what the government of UK has challenges in especially in two sectors where mostly the migrant workers are working. One is NHS, National Health Services, which is owned by British government, and second is the schools, where mostly the migrants teach, and then that's where the major challenge for British government is. So as part of this referendum, there is an Article 50 which has to be invoked by the UK as part of the European Union, and as the moment you invoke Article 50, within 2 years there is a duration where you need to exit out of Europe, European Union. And Britain has to come out with strange, you know, laws and regulations to continue its trading partnership with European countries, so that there is a less impact on their socio-economic conditions. Having said that, when I summarize it, majority of the people, or 50% or 60% of the people in Britain, doesn't want to exit out of European Union. However, there are some few economists or some capitalists within Britain want to get away from European Union with their small interest and concern. So, analysts still don't know whether it's good for Britain or bad for Britain, but I would say the Queen only can save Britain from this exit. Thank you all.
Any questions? Do you all have any questions?
Okay.
Thank you.